I am your science teacher. Today we will read the topic living things. So students, do you know what is living things? Living things have the ability to grow, move and breathe. Now you also know that living things need air, living thing need water, living things need food. Now I will discuss each topic one by one. Number one, living things need air. Students, all living things need air. When we breathe in, we take in oxygen into our body. So taking oxygen into our body is called breathing. You know, students, that fish also breathe through their gills. Animals that live on land take in air into their lungs. Plants also breathe. They take in air through the tiny holes in their leaves. So these tiny holes, they are the tiny holes in the leaves. So these tiny holes are called stomata. Now insects breathe through small holes on their side of their bodies. This was all about that living things need air. Number second, living things need water. Students, you know about that all living things is made mostly of water. 3/4 of our body is made up of water. When we feel thirsty, we need our body needs water. Students, plants also need water for to make their food in the presence of the sunlight. So if we do not water these plants, they will die and they will not survive. This was about living things need water. Point number third, living things need food. Dear students, all living things need food to stay alive. Food gives us energy and to grow and stay healthy. So this was all about these three points, that living things need air, living things need water, living things need food. Now we will discuss that living thing that there are three types of the living thing due to intake of the different type of foods. Number one, herbivores. Students, green plants can make their own food. Animals that do not prepare their own food, they take these green plants. So these animals are called herbivores. For example, goat, horse, ox, elephant. Goat, horse, ox, elephant. These are all herbivores. Number two, carnivores. Animals that eat meat of other animals are called carnivores. These are dog and lions. These are carnivores. Now, omnivores. Number third is omnivores. Human beings and other animals both eat plants and animals. These animals are called omnivores. So this was all about living things and their needs and the types. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. We will do reading of Unit 1, Living Things. Living things need air, food and water to live. Living things. There are many kinds of living things on Earth. Earth is the only planet which has water and a gas called oxygen. All living things need water and oxygen to live. They also need food. Living things need air. All living things need air. When we breathe in, we take in oxygen from the air. Oxygen helps to burn the food that is inside our bodies. This makes energy for our bodies. Energy helps living things to move and work. Taking oxygen into the body is called breathing. Fish breathe the oxygen that is dissolved in the water in which they live. They breathe through their gills. Animals living on land breathe by taking air into their lungs. Plants also breathe. They take in air through tiny holes in their leaves. These tiny holes are called stomata. Insects breathe through small holes on the side of their bodies. Students, you can see fish and their fish gills, that fish breathe through these gills. You can also see the small holes, which is called stomata. Cat, this is a small animal, and all animals that live on land breathe through their lungs. Now we will discuss about living things need water. Every living things is made up of mostly of water. 3/4 of our body is made up of water. Water helps to carry food from one part of the body to another. It stops the body from becoming dry. When we feel thirsty, it means our body needs water. Plants use water to make food. Water helps plants to stand upright. If we do not water a plant, it dries up and dies. Students, you can see in the picture that plants need water to make food because there is light, and plants take this light and they can make their food. The child, you can see the child that he drinks the water, so our body needs water. Page number 4. Living things need food. All living things need food to stay alive. Food gives them energy to grow and to stay healthy. Energy keeps their bodies moving and working. Food also repairs parts that have been worn out. You can see different kinds of food like eggs, apples, oranges, and chicken. Herbivores. Green plants can make their own food in the sunlight. Animals cannot make their own food. Some animals eat plants. They are called herbivores. Examples: cows, mice, horses, rabbits, and sheep are herbivores. You can see in the picture, green plants make their own food in sunlight. Cows are herbivores because they eat green plants or grass. Sheep are herbivores too. Number 2. Carnivores. Animals that eat the meat of other animals are called carnivores. For example, lion, tiger, dog, and cats are carnivores. Number 3. Omnivores. Human beings and some other animals eat both plants and animals. They are called omnivores. Hens and many birds like crows are omnivores. Hens are omnivores too. Now students, how is food used? The food that is taken into the body is broken down into simple particles. It is used by the body to grow. Some food is stored in the body and can be used later. In animals, the food is stored as a layer of fat under the skin. In plants, food is stored in the stems, roots, and seeds. It is also stored in the leaves and fruits. In some plants, food is stored in the roots. You can see in this picture, and it is clear to you. We are omnivores because we eat both plants and animals in the picture. This was about your unit 1. Students, hope you will understand and read it in your home. After reading, we will do question answers of unit 1, living thing. So students, today we will do the question answers. Answers the following questions. Question number 1, what do living things need to live? Answer is, all living things need oxygen, food, and water to live. Question number 2, how is oxygen used by the body? Answer, oxygen helps to burn the food that is inside our body. This makes energy for our bodies. Question number 3, what helps to carry food from one part of the body to another? The answer is, water helps to carry food from one part of the body to another. Now, question number 4. What happens to the food that is taken into the body? Answer, the food that is taken into the body is broken down into simple particles. Question number 5. Why is food important for the body? Answer is, food is important for the body to stay us alive. Food gives us energy to grow and stay healthy. This was all about question answers of living things. So students, I will give the homework. So learn question answers number 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that's all. This was all about question answers. Thank you.